It's been a very long time that I haven't created video related to CSS animation. So when I was in the TikTok and I thought, why don't I try this effect? So I have came up with the idea, and yeah, you can call 3D pop-up card. I do hope you guys will love this CSS 3D animation. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. Before jumping into the video, so this is the data that I have taken from the YouTube analytics, and you can see guys, like most of the people, they are watching my video but they are not subscribing. Like if you love the content of my YouTube video, please guys, don't forget to subscribe. I do have the folder named images, and inside that folder I do have two images, panda.jpg and panda.png. So these two are the images, and now let's create the index.html file. So inside the index.html file, if I type exclamation sign and hit that tab button, you'll get this basic HTML code. For the title, let's give 3D pop-up card. And inside the body tag, let's create the div with class name card. There is very few lines of CSS code, okay? So that's why I'm using internal CSS. So just below the title tag, let's create the style tag. So in order to prevent the browser's default margin, for the universal selector, I'm giving margin 0. Let's save, and if you have installed the live server in the VS Code, then in the index.html file, if you right click and hit that option called open with live server, then it will open it in your default browser. You can see it's running in local server. So now let's adjust this screen. So now let's style the body tag. For the body tag, I am giving the height of 100 VH. Similarly, let's give the linear background color. So for that, I am writing background image. Linear gradient. For the angle, I am giving 45 degrees, and for the second argument, I am giving coral. So let's change that color to a little bit darker. So for the second color, I am giving orange. Okay, if I save in the browser, now you can see. Now let's style this class card. So for the class card, let's give the height of 70 VH. For the width, I am giving 25 rem, and also let's give background color white. Okay, in the browser now you can see. Similarly for the body, let's give display flex, just to pay content to center, and also align items to center. This code will bring your div with class name card exactly at the center of your browser. You could create like two more divs, you know, like with a different class name, but I won't do that. Rather, I would be using after and before pseudo element. So for the class card, let's give the before pseudo element and also after pseudo element. So for the before and after pseudo element, I want to give the common style. For both before and after pseudo element, let's give position of absolute. So let's give the reference class card as a parent. So for the class card, let's give the position relative. Let's save. Let's give content nothing. Okay, for the before and after pseudo element, this property called content, this is compulsory, you have to give that, otherwise you won't be able to see anything. So now let's give the width. I'm giving width of 100%, and also let's give the height of 100%. Now let's copy this class card with before pseudo element and let's paste it. Now for the before pseudo element, let's give background image. For the background image in the URL, let's give that image path. So I'm writing images/panda.jpg. So remember, we have that panda.jpg image in our images folder. So now let's save it. Okay, in the browser now you can see we are not getting the proper size and the position of that image. Let's give background size. For the background size, I am giving cover. Okay, now you can see this is what you want. It's not that necessary. Now you can get rid of that background color. Now for the before and after pseudo element, let's give border radius. For the border radius, I am giving 1.5 rem. Now you can see rounded corners around the image. Now let's select this code and let's duplicate it. Now let's change that panda.jpg to panda.png. And for that before sudo class, let's change it to after sudo class. Now if you save it, you won't see any change. Okay, now if you comment that background image for the before sudo class, and now you can see this is the PNG image. Okay, that means the transparent image. So let's uncomment that code. Let's save it. Similarly for the before and after sudo class. Sorry, I think I have told for like sudo class, but this is the sudo element. Okay, sorry for that guys. So for the before and after sudo element, let's give background position of center. Now you can see the position of the image is exactly center. And also let's give transform. For the transform, I'm giving rotate x. For now let's declare the variable. So for the variable name, I'm giving rotate, and initially let's give this 0 degree, and also let's give scale. For the scale, I'm again declaring another variable named scale, and initially let's give the scale to 1. This is what the initial value of the transform property, okay, but we'll change it when you hover that class card. So before that, for the class card, let's give cursor to pointer. Okay, now you can see when you hover, you'll get that hand. Now for the class card, when you hover, let's change the CSS property of that before sudo element. Let's change the rotate variable's value. Okay, this rotate variable is declared at the top. Did you see that? Initially, we have given there 0 degree. Let's change the rotate variable to 65 degree. So when you hover, now you can see before sudo elements, background image is rotated, you know, but there is no smooth transition. Okay, so for that, for the both after and sudo element, let's give the transition. So for the transition, I'm giving 0.5 second transition duration. And also for the timing function, let's give is in and out. Now you can see when you hover, there is some smooth transition. So we want the different kind of effect. So this is not what you want. We want the 3D effect, you know. So in order to do that, for the same transform property, let's give the value of perspective. Okay, in the same line, don't get confused. For the perspective, I'm giving 20 frame. I can give something like 1000 pixel or any value, okay, but I'm giving 20 frame. So when you hover your class card, so this kind of 3D effect is the effect that you want, okay? But yeah, there are so many things to, you know, like change and improve. So we will do that. So first of all, for the class card, when you hover, let's change the after pseudo elements. Scale variable to 1.3. So same thing, we have already declared that scale variable at the top. You can see initially we have given the 1, but when you hover that class card, the after sudo element scale property will change it to 1.3. So when you hover the class card, you can give that blur effect for the before sudo element. So let's give that. So for that, let's write filter. Let's give blur. Let's give the value of 0.5 pixel. Now you can see that blurry image, okay, but when you hover that class card, the origin of that transform is at the center, okay. So let's change that transform origin. So for the before and after pseudo element, let's give the transform origin. So for the transform origin, I am giving bottom. Let's save it. So now let's adjust the screen. So finally, this is the effect that we are looking for. Similarly, you can change, you know, like lots of different values as well as the property, you know, like to make it more elegant, beautiful, you know, like you can experiment, okay? Something like, what if I change the perspective value to, instead of 20 frame, let's give 100 frame. Now you can see a bit different effect. Instead of rotate x to, let's give rotate y. Okay, now if you hover, you can see some totally different effect, you know. What if you change that rotate variable to -65 degree? You can see it rotates from your right side. Similarly, what if you give like rotate g? You can see like totally different effect. So yeah, you can experiment with this value, okay? Like you can change and you can see. So I would prefer rotate x. So this effect, I think, is the better effect. Let's copy this code and let's paste. Let's give the comma. instead of that after pseudo element, let's give before pseudo element. Now when you hover the card, both the after and before pseudo elements variable scale will change it to 1.3. now you can see it's looking much more better. Now let's press F11 key to take it to the full screen. So now when you hover your card, okay, this is the 3D effect that we are looking for. So guys, please let me know in the comment box, like, what are the things that I need to improve, the quality wise or the content wise. So what are the things that I need to improve? So let me know in the comment box so that I will give better content in the upcoming future. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also be sure to hit that subscribe button. Remember, there is always more to learn. So keep learning.